From the ancient paths made of ropes and plants to modern marvels at terrifying heights, today we look at the scariest bridges on Earth. Number 11. Da Nang Golden Bridge. Though comfortably secured in a massive pair of stone hands, the Golden Bridge just outside Da Nang, Vietnam, is still a stomach-churning path to walk. The 490-foot bridge is part of the Ba Na Hills Resort and acts as an incredibly vibrant overlook. It towers over the Ba Na Hills with an elevation of almost 4,600 feet above sea level. Luckily, the integrity of the structure is safe, with the aged appearance of the bridge being added for effect since the Golden Bridge was built in 2018. Number 10. Trift Suspension Bridge. Draping between two peaks within the Swiss Alps is a simple suspension bridge that's been around for nearly 10 years now. The bridge is situated in proximity to the region's Trift Glacier and surrounding Triftsee Lake, a major attraction of the Alps that attracts around 20,000 tourists annually. Prior to the bridge's construction, this glacier was used by visitors to access the Trift Hut, a cabin waypoint for hikers and mountaineers under the supervision of the Swiss Alpine Club. But as the glacier has melted, it was no longer at a height capable of traversing, and the need for the bridge was born. The first bridge was erected in 2004, but a sturdier replacement would come just 5 years later and continues to be in service today. To reach the bridge, one must take a cable car from Meiringen, then catch a gondola ride. From there, a 90-minute hike will bring you to this narrow, nerve-rattling walkway. Number 9. Kirikiridee Rope Bridge. Just off the northeast coast of Northern Ireland is the small island known as Kirikiridee. Locals have been constructing bridges to reach this rock for centuries, and with each new suspended path comes a new upgrade. Originally, the bridges to this island served the simple purpose of granting access to local salmon fishermen, who would use the island as an optimal casting point. But as time went on, the salmon of this region would dry up, making the jump from 300 salmon caught per day in the 1960s to 300 caught per season in 2002. Still, the island has remained a popular tourist stop thanks to the natural beauty of Kirikiridee. For many decades, the bridge was simply a single handrail with large gaps between the planks, making for a terrifying path at 98 feet above the rocky coast. But it has since been rebuilt multiple times, now with a wire rope and Douglas fir slats. It's still a fairly scary walk though, especially in inclement weather. And of the hundreds of thousands of visitors, many must be boated off the island when faced with the task of crossing the Kirikiridee Rope Bridge a second time. Number 8. Titlis Cliff Walk. As if climbing among the Swiss Alps wasn't frightening enough, mountaineers trekking along the Mount Titlis Cliff will also have to brave the Titlis Cliff Walk, a pedestrian bridge built at 10,000 feet above sea level. Crossing this path will require a 320-foot walk along a 3-foot-wide walkway, reducing balance and sending chills up a climber's spine, if the weather didn't do that already. A relatively new structure, the Titlis Cliff Walk was opened in December 2012, and dignitaries from 15 foreign nations attended the opening in honor of the 100th anniversary of the nearby Ingelberg-Jerschny Alp Railway. Unfortunately, on its opening day, a snowstorm hit the bridge, obscuring vision to just a few feet of clarity and causing the public opening of this bridge to push back one day. Despite the narrow walkway, its designers claim it was built to handle up to 120 mph winds and a maximum 500 tons of snow, claiming it to be 100% safe. Number 7. Royal Gorge Bridge. The highest bridge in the United States hangs over the Arkansas River at the center of Colorado near Canyon City. The star attraction of an amusement park of the same name, the Royal Gorge Bridge is a 1,260-foot-long stretch over a 955-foot fall. It gained popularity thanks to the 360-acre theme park in which it is situated. But even before the park's construction, this bridge was built to be a tourist site. When construction finished on the bridge after just 6 months in 1929, it was never intended to be driven on. The $350,000 bridge was able to be bypassed by road trippers thanks to Route 50, though other features added to the area helped ensure the lasting power of this wonder of the American West. Adding a funicular, a miniature railroad, an aerial tram, a sky coaster, gondolas, and a zipline, the Royal Gorge Bridge and Park is more than just a bridge. Still, with civilians allowed to drive over the bridge during certain hours, you'll be hard-sought to find a more thrilling bridge to cross in North America. Number 6. Kaikum Canopy Walk. The central region of Ghana is home to the 145-square-foot Kaikum National Park. Tropical forests blanket this region as an ecosystem rife with exotic animals like African elephants, monkeys, and antelopes, plus a whopping 266 species of birds as well. But given the lush, dense jungles of the park, witnessing such rare creatures would be difficult and potentially dangerous on foot. Luckily, the Kaikum Raccoon Canopy Walk exists. This great path among the treetops opened in 1995 on Earth Day and is composed of 7 different bridges that hang 130 feet above the jungle floor. More than 1,000 feet of bridge space allows visitors to get a closer look at Ghana's native wildlife. While the Canopy Walk looks like a classic rope bridge, it's actually been reinforced with wire ropes, aluminum, wooden planks, and safety netting to avoid potential falls. Regardless, between the unknown creatures in the dark corners of the jungle and the towering heights at which you'll have to walk, this series of bridges can still inspire fear in those who cross them. Number 5. Vine Bridges of Ia Valley. Long ago, one of the 3 legendary hidden valleys of Japan was home to more than 12 enthrallingly rustic bridges. These walkways within the West Ia Valley were crafted from wisteria vines that grew from either side of the Ia River. Once they had grown long enough, the vines were woven together along with planks separated by 8 to 12 inches of space. These bridges hang just 4.5 to 5 stories above the waters below, but crossing them was still tremendously treacherous thanks to the lack of any handrail. So when visitors unfamiliar with how to properly traverse the bridge would approach the natives of the Ia Valley, their movements often left the bridge swaying and bouncing, causing the potential invader to abruptly stop their advancement. Today, though, there are just 3 of these bridges left, all of which have been restored time and again for both preservation and safety purposes. Now they feature well-constructed sides and a closer plank spacing of about 7 inches between each. Still, the vine bridges of the Ia Valley remain a terrifying experience for any brave soul willing to attempt them. Number 4. Quehuachaca Bridge. In the Quehue district of Peru, stretching across the Apurimac River, is the final surviving Inca rope bridge. Crafted entirely out of ropes made from grass, this bridge is a historic phenomenon and preserved by the local community. Each June, Peruvian natives treat the restoration of the bridge as an annual tradition, with families banding together to make the ropes and mats necessary for reconstruction. This custom evolved from an ancient form of taxation, though it is done today to simply honor ancestors along with the fertility deity of the Andes, Pachamama. Majestic in person, this bridge's reverence is only outweighed by its risk. At just 4 feet wide and 92 feet long, visitors must brave a narrow path over a 220-foot drop in order to experience Quehuachaca Bridge in full. Number 3. Capilano Suspension Bridge. The Canadian wilderness is lush and verdant with forests stretching across the expanse of the Great White North, and there's no better way to see those woodlands up close than while crossing this bridge. The Capilano Suspension Bridge was first built in 1889 out of hemp ropes and cedar planks. By 1903, though, a steel cable was installed for stability. As the bridge would change ownership across the next century, it would endure many updates. Local natives installed totem poles in the surrounding woods around 1935, and in 1956, the bridge was completely reconstructed from scratch. Its current owner purchased the Capilano Suspension Bridge in 1983 and has seen the popularity of the bridge and surrounding park area surge. Around 1.2 million visitors came to witness this attraction annually, eager to gaze down at the Capilano River from 230 feet in the air. Number 2. Millau Viaduct. This masterpiece of modern architecture spans across the George Valley of the Tarn, a lake just outside of the French commune Millau. At a structural height of just over 1,100 feet, the Millau Viaduct is the tallest bridge in the world and cost 394 million euros to construct, the equivalent of $441.5 million. This cable-stayed bridge is meant for automobiles as part of the highway connecting Paris to the town of Béziers in the city of Montpellier. It was first opened at the end of 2004 after nearly 3 years in construction. The 8,000-foot-long Millau Viaduct was built to last much longer, though, with a predicted design life of 120 years. Despite being safely seated in your own vehicle, this is still a terrifying bridge to cross, mainly due to its immense height and slick, minimal design. While sturdy, the Millau Viaduct is missing much of the bulkiness of other bridges, and thus naturally elicits concern from travelers doubting its stability. With up to 25,000 vehicles crossing it daily, though, the Millau Viaduct has proven itself reliable. Number 1. Zhang Zhaji Glass Bridge. Built within the Zhang Zhaji National Forest Park, this 1,400-foot-long glass suspension bridge connects 2 giant cliffs 984 feet above the treetops below. Originally, it was intended to carry up to 800 people at a time and expected daily foot traffic of 8,000 people per day. But park authorities learned quickly of their folly, attracting 10 times that amount throughout the first 2 weeks of the bridge's opening. It has since been improved and updated, allowing visitors access to cross as well as partake in its 935-foot bungee jump, which is considered the highest jump on Earth.